Hi guys, this is Janice, and today I'm going to teach you how to make this isolated kingdom inspired by MaxterMooch. And I've been wanting to make this for the longest time now, so here it is, a tutorial. So here's the material that you'll be needing. And also you'll be needing a clear box, just a small one will do, and I got mine off Daiso. And mine's slightly bigger than MaxterMooch one, but that's okay because as long as it's not too big, it will work. And for this, the box cover kind of can't really secure up if you get what I'm trying to say in the video above. But do not worry because the resin will be securing them after that. So right now, just grab a few scrap clay and just, you know, mesh them up together for the base, grass patch, I mean. And then just kind of blend them together and just get your desired size. After that, just grab a little piece of green clay and just flatten them down. And to the thinnest you can go, and after that just cover it up. This way it will help you to save green clay, so just kind of stretch it a little bit to cover them as much as possible, but don't stretch them too much because it might end up tearing the clay apart like mine. So I'm just covering up the torn part with rubbing tool, just kind of blend them together. After that I'm just taking my knife to trim off the excess that I can't really cover up. And this is how it looks like after you are done. And I'm just grabbing a toothbrush to kind of give it a little texture. You can use aluminium foil if you want to, but I'm using either tool or toothpick to kind of give it a little more detailing. That's what I prefer. It's up to you whether you want to, you know, texture it or not. And this is how it looks like after you are done. Just give it a little good tap on the top to kind of secure the loosened clay piece together. If not, they will just kind of fall off. After that, just grab this really light dirty brown color clay. Just trim it off and kind of get this rectangular shape. And this will be the main building for the castle. After that, just grab make two of these cylinders to kind of place it beside, on both sides of the castle. And this is just the part of the castle. So just kind of, you know, shape them nicely. After that, just place them beside of each other and make sure you secure them afterwards with TRS or metal wires. After that, just add two of these flat clay on top. Just roll them into a ball and just kind of flatten them down and just place it on top. And I'm doing the same thing for the main castle as well. It's just this rectangular shape. After that, just grab two of these snakes and just kind of twist them together to get this kind of like fish braid effect, and just place them on top of the castle, at the front side of the castle, I mean. After that, just I'm making this really small little rectangular shape of clay and just place it on top. And right now I'm making the roof for both cylinder, so I'm just making this pretty small triangular roof and just place it on top. And for the main castle, I'm using different color because I ran out of the same color, so just make it slightly bigger than both cylinder ones and just use a needle tool to kind of texture it to give them kind of like a brick effect, if you get what I'm trying to say. Just look at the video itself and just follow my lead and you'll kind of get what I'm trying to say. And I'm doing the same thing to the lower part of the castle as well. After you are done, I'm just going to use my needle tool to give off a little detail on top of the roof because it looks kind of dead and plain if I don't do that. So I'm just drawing this triangular indent on it. after that, I'm using my big dot dotting tool to kind of make a little indent on the on three of them to kind of represent the door. And after that, I'm using this dark brown clay to kind of fill it in. And I'm using my dotting tool to kind of give it a little detail again. After that, just give a little trim to finish off the base. After that, I'm using this red color clay and shaping them into this triangular shape. And with this metal wire I'm sticking in to secure them together, this is kind of like the flat. And I'm securing my castle with TRS to the grass patch and also this treasure box that I made a while ago. And also I add a little flowers and stuff to kind of finish off the look. And right now I'll be teaching you how to make this dragon. I mean, I have a tutorial on it, so if you want to learn how to make the tutorial, the dragon, I will be linking the tutorial in the description box below. So feel free to check them out if you want to learn how to make the dragon itself. Right now I'm just grabbing some acrylic paints and I'm just painting on the outside of the box some clouds. So just follow what I'm doing right now, just add a couple of clouds and after that, just go on and bake your clay. And this is how they look like after they are done baking. And I'm using some black acrylic paint, mixing with some water and just kind of giving the castle a little paint to make them look kind of like rusty and dirty and old looking instead of all clean looking. After that, just use a tissue and wipe it off with your acrylics too much. And I'm also giving the dragon a little bit of finished look because the chalk pastel didn't kind of give them the look I wanted. So I'm just kind of painting them. After that, just go on and glaze our castle. I'm glazing my triple tick, you can see from the video. I'm just kind of giving them some rough glaze. And after that, just grab some glue and I'm gluing some rhinestone to the castle and the treasure box itself. I'm just adding two of them, that's it. And right now I'm grabbing some chopped pastel, blue color one, and I'm mixing them together with my resin. So just get your resin mix and just, you know, mix them with some chopped pastel to kind of make the water itself. After that, just add it onto the cover or the container you have. And that's how mine looks like. And I just go and grab my castle and just place them in to the desired place and I just cover up with my box itself, and this will kind of end off. After that, I just glue my dragon on top of the castle. And just I'm gluing it with my E6000. After that, you are done. So that's how it looks like. It's pretty simple to make, but it can take up a lot of time. And I really hope you do like this video. If you do, just give me a thumbs up. And yeah, share this around. And I really do hope you enjoy it. And goodbye. Have a nice day. See you! And remember to follow me on social medias and to just, you know, follow me on Instagram to check out what video I'm making it next. And yeah, that's all. Goodbye.